We're at V Site, and this is where the components for the Trinity device were assembled. This was before the device, it was also called the gadget, was sent down to Trinity and Trinity Site in southern New Mexico. And other work was done here at V Site before then to support the development of the Fat Man weapons. So some early design work was also conducted here at V Site. But the gadget, or the Trinity device, which was assembled here in this building, was very significant because it was the first nuclear explosion in the world. It was detonated at Trinity Site on July 16th of 1945.
In order to develop the little boy weapon, they needed to test the ballistics of the gun that was actually inside the weapon, and that's why this is called gun sight. These are poured concrete, very thick-walled, bunkered structures that are partially covered by earth. The reason for this is when they were conducting the gun tests up above, it was unsafe to be up there. Everybody involved in the project had to be down in here in these bunkers. There was also a periscope tower connected to this building so that the scientists inside could actually view the tests remotely.
We call this building the Slotin Building. And that's because on May 21st, 1946, so after the end of World War II, but still part of the Manhattan Project era here at Los Alamos, Louis Slotin was conducting an experiment in this building. It was an experiment called Tickling the Dragon's Tail. It involved a subcritical mass of plutonium, and he basically had this sphere of plutonium that was being reflected by hemispheres of beryllium. So they were being kept apart by a screwdriver type implement, and that allowed them to be kept apart safely. But the screwdriver slipped, and when the hemispheres joined up, there was basically a burst of radiation, and Louis Slotin died 9 days later.
Emilio Segrè's chemistry group identified that the plutonium coming from Hanford could not be used in the gun assembled method. An entirely new design of nuclear weapon had to be developed, and that was eventually the implosion method, which was the Fat Man weapon. But it was here at Pajarito Site where that really important chemistry research was conducted by Emilio Segrè and his group. Now, there were two cabins. The pond cabin was primarily used by Segrè's group as an office, a library, a place to spend the night when they had to stay down here. The forester's cabin was actually where the chemistry experiments were set up.